Hey everyone, it's Becky. I just have a project to share with you guys. It's not a design team project, which is amazing, but I just put this project together for my friend Becky Long. So if you're watching the video, she's got it. And I made this for her birthday, even though it's like 2 months late almost. Yeah, it's like almost 3 months late, 2.5 months, but still a thought that counts. When it was her birthday, all the new releases were coming out, and Prima Epiphany was one of them. And then I seen this video on Ustream on this mini album from Steph Miller. She's an educator for Prima, and so I knew that I wanted to get this mini album kit to give to her. So I put it together, and of course, I had to wait for the kit to come out. I got it from Scrapbook Diaries. So it would have been late anyway. So you get it from Scrapbook Diaries, and see if I can get it to focus. This is all the stuff that you get in the kit. And then the only thing that's not in the kit is this, like the distress tool and the glue and the crocodile and like all that stuff. I did buy the Color Bloom spray, the Pastel Sunshine. Let me just show you. And then I'll post the link to it. It's on YouTube now, but it's the Ustream video that you can. She tells you how to put this together. She shows you like two or three pages to do, and then the third one I just kind of guessed off of just by watching her flip through it. And so you can pretty much do it. You just buy the wood frames from Michaels or Hobby. She says Hobby Lobby. And then you can make it out of whatever paper and just follow the pattern for her inside pages. So I'm going to try and run through this really quick because I'm doing this without my older kids here. My younger kids are watching TV, so hopefully they let me get through this before they come pounding on my door. So anyways, I pretty much did everything that Steph did on hers, like as far as like decorating and embellishing and stuff. So I just she did the beautiful bird, and that's from the ephemera pack. And then these vellum flowers come in the kit, and then all these flowers and the leaves here come in the kit. And then this is part of the ephemera pack, the baker's twine and the stick pins. They send you a pack of those. And then the only thing is different that I did on this side is the stick pin. I just stuck it under there to kind of hide my glue from the flower. And then this part, or this ephemera piece. And then this is from just my stash from the Epiphany collection. I put that flower together because I didn't have another flower that I like to put there. So I just made that one out of the paper flower collection from the Epiphany. And then she tells you how to do it on the Ustream video, and then in the instructions you gesso the frame on the outside, and then I sprayed it with the Color Bloom spray. And then the other one I used was the Prima Chalk Edger, the Colt's Foot Petals, and then it's a wood one. It's a Prima Chalk Edger, and it's something wood. I forget the name. So I just kind of, just to put a little bit of brown in there. And then I stamped it with the stamp set that they send you in the kit. And some archival ink. And then I did the pages just like she did. There's the Prima trim that they send you in the kit. And then there's some more of the baker's twine. And then these little charms come in the ephemera kit. There's the clock and the key. And then the inside, there's a butterfly from the ephemera. And I stickled the edges, like she said. I did edge punch this page with my edge punch, I think my Martha Stewart one. And then this journal tag comes with the paper. It's on the back side of a pattern paper. And I just cut it, except for this I glued down because I didn't quite see it sheet, it flips. So mine's glued down. And then I put these two pieces of ephemera, and then I cut this out of the paper. And then this is another flower from my Epiphany stash. And then there's some leaves that come with the kit. And then I distressed everything, and I just slightly distressed it, and then I went over like all the pages with the coltsfoot petal and a little bit of the brown one. I wish I could remember the name of that one. I should have left it out. And then on this back of this page, this vase is made out of vellum, like she says. And then I put some more ephemera up there. And then over here on this page is another page, like she shows you. And I made the pocket and put the ephemera right there. I stickled the butterfly wings. Hopefully you guys can see that. Kind of twinkling. And then the clock behind it. And then there's a tag that I did. And then this is, on this side, I think this is the only part that I kind of screwed up on. It's been a while since I've videoed Mini, sorry. Here on this, where you cut this out, I think it's supposed to be part of this paper. And see, I didn't do that. And I think I actually used some of my 6x6 paper pad behind here. So, I don't know. I'll redo one or do another one someday and see if I can get it to look right. Because it kind of looks, hers looks like it, when she folds it out, it like blends into this paper and mine doesn't. So, but that's okay. It's still cute. So there's that. And then to do like a picture or journaling. And then a little banner with an eyelet, is that what they're called? And then there's, you know, some more journaling or a picture, whatever she wants to do with with the pages. And then this one's made out of the acetate or transparency. And then I made a pocket, and mine, she has like where she draws her little thing out to do this decorative edge. What I did was I took a piece of paper for my pattern, and then I just traced this out on it, and then I ended up, using it for this. I wish I could show you, but I have it behind my little backdrop there. So you just take, a piece of paper and you trace it just from the half over, and then take the piece of paper and fold it in half, so it's this width. And then cut it out, and then you can take and put it and use it for the decorative edge on this. So that's what I did. And then I put a couple of banners like Steph did, and then one of the journaling cards. And then over here is just a big picture mat or whatever, and then I did the baker's twine through the transparency. And then the eyelets and the rings, the wood and everything comes in the kit. And then on this one, this is the one I guessed on, but I did leave this so it flips open so you can write on this. And then it's just cut, and I kind of cut out the bird a little bit on this card. And then I glued it in. And then on this side, there is some more ephemera. And then, but over here, let me show you. I made it so it's a pocket. And then inside of it, hopefully if it'll come out, there's a little tiny book thing. It's not going to come out. I'm going to have to fix it. Hopefully it's not stuck in there. Okay, there we go. There's a little book from the ephemera. So on this page, I just did it so that It's just a little pocket, and then I glued this down to it, but I left the side so that a picture could tuck behind it. So see, you could tuck a picture behind there. And then I fussy cut out this right here from the paper, and then there's a flower from the kit, and then the leaves, and it's on another piece of acetate or transparency. And then on this, I just cut that out. I think I got that out of my 6x6, and I just put it down the side. And then there's this side is just the paper, one big piece of paper for a picture. And then, like I said, I distressed everything and put that Coltsfoot petal chalk ink. And then here on the back is the wood frame, and this has the butterflies going down it. And then up here's more ephemera, and then some leaves tucked behind it. And then another flower from the kit. And then these little paper flowers behind are from my stash, and I just cut it in half and I kind of tucked it in there under that flower. And then that's the leaf from the kit. And then I painted, and not painted, but I gestured it kind of a little bit here on the side, and then I went over the Coltsfoot petal and the brown chalk ink. And then here on the inside, or this, I think I kind of did this backwards too. I probably should have put paper over it, but then I thought it would look funny because there would be a space, but I kind of like it because she can put a paper or picture here, I mean, and then if she wants, she can decorate the edge. So that's the back, and then I just signed it. So, yeah, I'll put the link below and go check out if it's still available. So you can go check out the kit because it comes with tons of stuff. So I hope Becky likes it. I hope you like it, and let me know what you guys think, and I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.